Hi, I'm Andres and this is Androtics, a channel for creating robotics and AI projects. This is my very first project where I'm going to record everything. I will do a series of videos where I explain the different approaches and steps in building a quadruped robot, totally from scratch. A quadruped robot is a four-legged robot, similar to a dog. I'm calling this the Pavlov project in relation with the Pavlov's experiments with dogs. Okay, in this part number one, I will give an introduction of the project, how to consider the given problem as well as explain the design I will follow. But before getting into more details, let's get some ideas from other quadruped robots already existing. I've been studying many quadruped robots from other people, but the best one for me is the famous SpotMini from Boston Dynamics. Boston Dynamics is an engineering and robotics design company which has developed some of the best stable and dynamic robots. This is how SpotMini looks like. You can see all the predecessors of SpotMini, the smallest one. The company have been improving the performance of their quadruped robots and making them smaller. But let's focus on the movement. It's so natural, and the stability of the robot is just amazing. This is why I decided to apply a similar design to my quadruped robot. SpotMini has also a robotic arm for object manipulation, but I'm not planning to add this feature right now. Okay, let's study what we see. Each paw of the robot has a total of 3 joints, the first one in the shoulder, moving the paw left and right. The second one in the shoulder as well, moving the paw backwards and forward. And the last one is the elbow. You might realize that this is different from a quadruped animal, which has more joints. But this doesn't mean that the movement of a dog is more optimal, maybe it is more flexible. In fact, more joints demand more energy power and more complex movements. So let's keep it simple. Other thing we can realize about the SpotMini is that there are no spine joints, which means that the torso of the robot is rigid. From the Boston Dynamics website, we can get some information about the physical features such as the height, the weight, the power, the type of actuators, which are electric, and the number of joints, 3 for each paw plus the arm joints. Based on this information, 3 motors are needed for each paw, but each motor should have high torque to support the robot, and also high speed for rapid movements. Here is the design of the robot I'm going to build. And as I said, it is based on a SpotMini. For instance, the size is quite similar and they have also 3 joints in each paw. I do not expect to get the same result as Boston Dynamics. This is my own design, and it will have its own limitations. Let's see the components closer. Here we have the actuator for the first shoulder joint, a DC motor. This is a bearing for the joint axis, and this is a potentiometer to track the position of the motor. The second actuator is another DC motor, the same as the first one, but this one has a double axis. The potentiometer along this axis is used to track its position. These are 2 aluminum bars which are the upper bones of the paw. And the last actuator, this is a linear electric actuator for the elbow joint. Here we have 2 bearings to allow the elbow movement, and a potentiometer to measure this motion. And finally, an aluminum bar which formed the lower bone of the paw. So this is one paw of the design, but all paws have the same configuration, and therefore they will behave the same. Okay, based on this design, let's focus on the hardware. Starting with the motors, this is the DC motor I decided to use for the first shoulder joint. And these are the specifications. The speed is important since it affects directly the walking movement of the robot. It must be high enough while keeping the torque high. And the torque, this is the measurement of the strength, can be thought as if the motor is able to rotate a weight of 40 to 80 kg, depending on the voltage applied, connected to a bar of 1 cm. This torque is quite high, and the price of this motor isn't too bad. The DC motor used for the second shoulder joint has the same specification as the first one, but this one has a double axis. This fact increases the price of the motor. But the double axis is necessary to be connected to the 2 aluminum bars. Finally, the last actuator for the elbow joint is a linear electric actuator with the following specifications. The force here is 400 newtons, which means that the motor is able to load about 40 kilograms. Sadly, the price of this actuator is higher than the other two. For the control, I'll use this driver which allows me to control two DC motors. Connected to this driver, an Arduino Due will control the speed and position of the motors. This is a 32-bit car with a high clock speed, enough to control a total of 12 motors of the quadruped robot. And we have 12 analogic inputs for the 12 potentiometers. Nice! Okay, this is a diagram showing the control levels of the motors. The first level is the motor itself, connected to the motor driver which is connected to the Arduino Due. Arduino will be carrying the low-level control of all motors, while a computer connected to the Arduino will command the positions and speed. In this computer, Ross will be running the working algorithms for the quadruped robot. Where is Ross, you may ask? Ross is the abbreviation of Robot Operating System, a set of software and tools for developing robot applications. Most of the current research in robotics use it. It is open source, and you can find a lot of free tutorials and a huge community in the website. Okay, let's list all the components I need and see what is the money inversion. 4 DC motors for the first shoulder joint. Another 4 for the second shoulder joint. And 4 linear actuators for the elbows. 6 motor drivers to control the 12 motors. An Arduino Due. 4 bearings with support for the first shoulder joint. 8 bearings with support for the elbow movement. A power supply for the motors. Right now I'm not planning to add batteries. This will be done in the future. 12 potentiometers to track the position of the 12 motors. 8 shaft coupling to connect the potentiometers to the joint axis. And aluminum bars. I don't know the amount yet, but I expect to spend 40 euros. And this is the sum of the first inversion, almost 400 euros. These are cheap but strong motors and hopefully I will get a good performance in my quadruped robot. Also, I still need to buy some other components, but for now we have enough to start. Okay, this is the end of this video, I hope you like it and subscribe for more updates in this project. See you next time, bye!